Marcus and Hannah is a firm key in the piece on adolescent dating violence. I feel I should just throw it out there that we're putting a trigger warning on our piece for the subject of adolescent dating violence and the situations that result in it. So anyways, forum theatre. Forum theatre differs from traditional theatre in a few senses. While traditional theatre has you as an audience watching a play and trying to understand the issues that happen during the play, understand the perspectives and the characters that are played out during it, and leaving you, if it's good, with some emotions and thoughts after it, a forum theatre piece has you watch a play, try and understand the issues that occur in it, try and understand the perspectives and behaviors of the characters, but also has you, on having some emotions and thoughts, act these out during the foruming segment. More on that later. I'll first begin by introducing my actors on stage. So, let's begin with an introduction, starting with the lady in the colourful tank top.
Hi, I'm Shamita.
I'm Sophie.
I'm Singhao.
I'm Zana.
And I'm Samuel.
So, you will notice that our actors, are holding certain objects in their hands. These are signifiers. These signifiers are important because when they put them on, they will take on the role that these objects signify. So, let's give them a minute to put them on. And when they do so, they will take on the characters in our play. So, let's begin with an introduction of our characters, beginning once more with the lady in the colourful tank top.
Hi, my name is Emily. I've been friends with Marcus and Nick for the longest time. I come from a family where my dad earns the money and my mom takes care of the house. We are very happy. I believe that men and women should act in a way that is expected of them. I want to fit into society's standard of a good woman.
Hi, my name is Sarah. All my life, men have been disrespectful, bad, and just downright assholes to me and other women around me, whether be it in the form of being made fun of, being harassed, or even being dismissed. And now even my best friend Hannah is being abused by her boyfriend. So that's why I want to fight against the abuse and against the stereotypes that girls have. I wish that my best friend Hannah would feel the same too.
Hi, I'm Nick. I want to be a good guy, to respect women, as back home, dad will always respect mom and vice versa. Hence, I do believe that men and women should be treated equally.
Hi, I'm Hannah, and I come from a strict... I'm raised by my strict parents who hold strong mindset of how a girl should be. They don't know about my relationship with Marcus, and I am aware that I'm in an abusive relationship when Marcus disrespects me. That is why I want to fight to be respected despite being a woman.
I'm Marcus, and as my girlfriend, I think I treat her well. I watch over her. I'm sweet to her. I think we deserve each other. I like my parents. My dad hits my mom sometimes. But my mom doesn't listen to my dad, so I don't know. Anyway, I want to be, I should be, a man who leads those around me.
Alright, everyone got that? Good. I'll allow my actors to go up off stage to begin preparing for the show. In the meantime, I have three tasks for you as an audience. The first is to consider this question. How do gender stereotypes affect our relationships as teenagers, our romantic relationships as teenagers? The second task I have for you is, whilst watching the play, I want you to try and recall after the play, certain moments during it where you felt strong emotions, where you saw instances of unfairness and injustice, where you came across scenes that provoked your thoughts. And the third task I have for you is to, on seeing these moments, think about how you can potentially replace a character on stage in order to deal with the issue that's happening, with the problem that's happening. Is everyone clear?
Yes.
All right. So without further ado, we will begin with our production of Marcus and Hannah.
They said to have a happy relationship.
You have to be a good woman.
To be understanding.
To be forgiving.
To be patient.
To be self-sacrificing, to be always supportive of your man.
A nice woman would simply understand.
They told me I would soon be the man of the house when I was just 6 years old. They said,
men don't feel and men don't cry.
Man up, they told me.
Man up, young boy.
I shoveled my emotions to the corner of my mind. Talk with my fist. Look them in the eye.
There is only one use for my mouth, and it is not for speaking. A man is most powerful. When my hand he is grabbing, I did not think, run! As he grabbed me by the wrist. I thought, this is just the same, like those in the movies.
They laughed at me for never landing a kiss, as my pockets are devouring my sweaty fists. They shamed me for my lack of experience.
Only those who went in are victorious.
At least, this is what we've been told, though no one knows why. But to bring about a change, that is what I'm gonna try. I'll build my own world full of fairness and love. To be respected as a woman, that is what I deserve.
I've been thinking about what we did the other night. I feel weird about it.
Why?
I feel uncomfortable, babe.
Hannah, if you ever feel uncomfortable, you can tell me. You have to stay in this relationship too.
I know. That's why I want you to delete the pictures.
That's what's bothering you? Okay. I'm eating the ham. Don't you trust me?
Okay, wait.
Okay, close your eyes.
Why?
You'll see.
Necklace?
No, it's not a necklace. Happy birthday, Hannah. It's my job to pamper you, isn't it? Don't ever take it off. Just won't keep everything. Alex, huh? I knew it!
Knew what, babe?
You've been seeing other guys behind me, is that right?
No!
Then who is this dog?
He's just a classmate, babe.
Why so defensive?
Babe! I have a boyfriend. Stop talking to me, motherfucker. Why do you always jump to conclusions? Look, it's just school stuff.
Then why must he ask you?
I'm the class chairperson.
This is why you shouldn't have taken on the role.
God's sake, babe.
For God's sake, God's not even pleased with you. You think he likes a girl who throws themselves at other guys?
I don't understand you. You're just trying to pick a fight with me, right?
That's because you're always doing something wrong. Only know how to ruin my mood.
She's yours, isn't she? Don't worry.
Christ, man.
Come on, I'll be so lucky to be in your shoes. You're the man.
Guess you're right. So, how are things with you and Emily?
I don't know if she's interested.
To be honest, I didn't think that you would like her. Since the three of us started hanging out.
Yeah, but she's a woman now.
Nice, I said, right?
But I don't know if I'm your kind.
You need to take initiative. Girls want a guy who can care for them, protect them, give them a sense of security. Look at me. This is why I get girls so easily.
Never fail to rub it in.
This is for your own good, man. You thank me for rubbing it in when you don't have to rub one off yourself.
You speak as if you're
getting
over the
bed. Maybe I have.
Really?
Stop it. That's not what you said the first time you saw it.
You're so annoying!
Penis. Alrighty. What the fuck's the problem? You're being a real bitch, you know that?
You're disgusting!
What? But Hannah, you can't take a joke.
What's wrong with you? You don't have to make such dirty jokes. You think it's funny to humiliate me, huh? You don't respect me at all.
Yeah, and talking to other guys is respecting me.
What? You're still talking about that?
What has gotten into you? Oh, did Sarah say something?
No, you always think my opinions come from someone else.
You've never complained about anything. So why are you bringing this up now?
You keep saying that you want to change. You keep saying that you want to change. But are you really trying? All you do is hurt me. You're really just like your father.
What the hell did you just say? Don't compare me to that spider. Stop. I don't hate women. You think I'm a bad guy? I'm the only one keeping this relationship together while you're always at the side thinking of God knows what.
I wonder why I'm still with you.
You say that again?
Guys.
This deck is truth, and this deck is there. I'll go first. Well, this is awkward. What is my favorite porn genre? Well, you know, not all guys watch porn, right?
You sure about that? I thought your favorite genre was BDSM.
Marcus!
Oh, come on, Hannah. I said you're so pure.
You stop being such a douchebag to Hannah.
And you stop always having something to say.
Okay, Sarah, why don't you go next?
I'm not going to answer this.
Come on, it's just a game.
Yeah, chill, Sarah. Why do you have to take everything so seriously? Ooh, SMK. Who amongst us would you screw, marry, or kill?
I wouldn't screw anybody.
You sure about that? Not even Emily or Hannah? I thought you were less.
Shut up, Marcus!
Don't be upset, Hannah. She was never going to choose you anyway. Your tits are an ass.
Not cool, man.
What? I'm just stating the truth. You've seen them too.
Yeah.
What are you guys talking about?
Give it back. Give it back.
Stop! Stop! Stop it! Stop it!
What the hell, Hannah?
You said you deleted them!
I'm not talking about this now!
Please give me the phone!
Stop it!
Marcus!
Why are you just asking
for it? Marcus, what's wrong with you? She's a girlfriend, dude.
Stay out of this thing.
No, I mean it. Stop treating her like this.
Trying to act like such a decent guy, huh? You sure didn't act this way when I showed you the nudes. Bloody hypocrite!
You fucking creeps! Marcus, how could you do something like that? I'm done, Marcus! I'm done!
What do you say?
It's over! I can't do this anymore!
You bitch! You didn't
even I'm gonna call the police!
Yeah, you do!
Sorry, you can't call the police, sir.
You had Hannah, screw off!
You're actually defending him right now? You don't understand! What the hell is wrong with you, Hannah? If you're not going to help yourself, I really don't know who can. I don't know what to do. Sarah! Look what you've done!
Even your best friend left you. Who else will be here for you now? I'm giving you one last chance. One click on this phone and your whole life will be over forever.
Stop.
And then your family, you know what? Slut your minute after it is!
Nick, come on, we have to help her!
Forget it. It's not a shit to do with.
What kind of man are you?
Ah! Why do you keep making me hurt you? You know I love you, but why do you keep making me hurt you? You're not in the right state of mind right now. Come back to me and everything will be just like it was. Happy. You think I want things to be happy too? You're being selfish. Everything's gonna be alright, Hannah. Everything's gonna be fine.
someone is considered an apprehension. These feelings are normal after watching something like that. So, we have come to the forming segment of our play. To begin with, let me reintroduce my actors and the characters they play on the stage once more. Forum in the past was a Roman municipium where people congregated together in order to discuss issues and work towards resolving them. So hope that we today can come together and try to work together in this space to solve the issue that happened just now. So let's begin first by addressing our characters wise, starting once again with the lady in the colorful tank top, Emily.
I want to fit into society's standard of a good woman.
I am Nick, and I want to be a good man, to respect women.
I'm Sarah, and I want to fight against the stereotypes they are for girls.
I'm Hannah, and I want to be respected despite being a woman.
I'm Marcus, and I want to lead those. I want to be a man who leads those around me.
So, you will recall that I gave you three tasks just now, at least I hope that you recall these three tasks. The first was the question of how gender stereotypes affect relationships amongst us teenagers. The second task was to watch the play and try and consider moments where you felt there was injustice, unfairness, and the third task was to consider how you as an audience might try and take the role of a character in order to try and resolve the problem that's happening. But that leads us to our first question, doesn't it? Was there a problem just now? I see some of you nodding your heads. But first, what was that problem exactly? Perhaps a hand up if you want to answer that question. Or you can just shout it out.
Manipulative boyfriends.
That's good.
Gender roles being projected onto relationships.
Yep. I think these two things are very closely related. The idea that guys and girls hold certain roles, attitudes, and values that affect their relationships, that cause power imbalances. And perhaps the issue that we should try and address is that of Hannah's abuse at the hands of Marcus. So that leads us on to us as an audience trying to identify a scene in which we think we can try and change in order to resolve the horrible circumstances of the last scene. Would anyone like to give an answer? Are there any characters maybe that you felt could have done something, who were in a position during the play to do something?
I think Nick could have done something more. I mean, since he is a male himself. I mean, not saying that females in the play can't do anything more, but like because of Marcus' character and how he portrayed gender roles, then maybe Nick could have done something to stop.
So you think Nick might have done a better job during the play at trying to stop the problem because of his connection with Marcus?
Yes.
And which scene do you think Nick could have done something? This is not just a question for a person volunteering the answer, but it's for the whole audience as well. Where do you think Nick could have done something to solve the problem?
When you first see the video.
When you saw the pictures, they were actually pictures, pictures of Hannah.
Then
he
could pretend to be excited about it, then
he
take the phone, then he delete it.
Would you like to try that? Regardless, does everyone think that perhaps we can start our first intervention where Marcus shows Nick the nudes? Alright, so we have one strategy. Nick could have tried to have taken the nudes from Marcus by guile, tricking him. But does anyone have any other options before maybe a volunteer steps up to try and fill in the shoes of Nick?
I feel that Hannah, as a friend, she could actually talk to Emily because I feel that Emily was influencing. Who's that?
That's Sarah.
Sarah's
character.
Yeah, because Emily was trying to like she was trying to influence Hana's mindset towards how she could handle the situation better. But then on the other hand, Hana was just, she was saying facts on how Hana should handle the situation better. But then Emily was just trying to, she was like blocking every single like thing that Sarah could do.
This was when Sarah pulled Hana apart from the interview, right?
Yeah, and then that part when three of them were at the beat, and then
Sarah.
I can't remember names.
Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah, like, she was trying to, like, she was saying, like, how all, like, boys are like that. I mean, like, they only talk about sex. But then, on the other hand, Emily was just saying, like, oh, they are just boys. Boys will be boys. I mean, that Hannah, Sarah could actually, like, talk to Emily. And then try to, like, change the situation in the sense that three of them can have the same mindset. I mean, I don't know if it's possible, but then talking to Emily first would be better. Because Emily was trying to make the situation worse by saying that it's okay, like, you should suck it up to that.
That's my suggestion. Can I clarify one thing though? What do you mean when you say that Sarah should try and change Emily's mindset? What about Emily's mindset do you want to change?
Like, try to, like, talk to Emily, like, no, you should have this mindset that girls should suck up to boys, the male's expectation of how they should react. I bet talking to her would be better, because in a sense that both of them can then talk to Hannah about how she can handle the situation of her
words.
Okay.
Would you like to give that a try?
Yeah.
Oh.
First, let's introduce your name to our audience.
Hi, my name is Nabila.
Okay, so Nabila would like to take on the role of Sarah in the barbecue scene by trying to influence Emily in order to get them both on the side in order to have a stronger standing amongst girls.
And yeah, can
mark.
I ask what's her one?
Sure.
I want to fit into society standard of good woman.
Why?
Would you like to rewatch the scene one more time?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just focus on the girls and barbecue.
I don't think I'm trying to fit society
lately. He just accused me of trying to cheat on him.
Why would he even think that?
I don't know. It's just one of his flaws. I've been thinking of how I should talk to him about it.
Well, he okay, isn't just me who prefers a guy who cares too much than too little. I'm sorry for eavesdropping, but I think that's just Marcus's way of showing he loves you.
Emily, there's a difference between love and Stockholm Syndrome. Hana, I really think you should break up with him already.
Okay. So I forgot to clarify that. In case you're wondering, you can say stop if you want to stop playing by the rules. Okay. So, who would you like to
Sarah.
Okay. Where exactly would
you
like to be?
He just sleep a huge sleep.
That's an overreaction, Sarah.
Oh.
I should break up with him.
That's an overreaction, Sarah.
What do you mean when you say an overreaction? She's your friend, you should understand her situation better. Are you studying with the guys? She's in a dangerous situation. You should do something about it too.
Okay, but really, like, what, did she even try to talk to Marcus properly? Does she understand what she... What
I mean, did you?
I talked to Marcus a few times, and there is some time where he showed that he's changing, then he'll go back to his normal self.
Yeah, see? She said it herself. I think we should... Do you want us to talk to Marcus together?
No, he'll be angry. He doesn't know that I told you.
Wait, Hannah, why did Marcus even do to you? Like, why are you acting like this? I don't think he's ever hurt you in any way, right? He loves you so much. He treats her really well.
If I tell you, will you don't tell Marcus this?
Okay, I will tell Marcus.
I'm not happy in this relationship.
Okay.
He's been controlling me, my every move.
Yeah, I feel that Marcus should get to that. And you should know better, you're a lady yourself.
Yes, I understand, but I know that Marcus loves her a lot. You know he's
but
never been...
love doesn't mean that you can control her.
I don't think he's controlling her. I think he's just...
Do you think that he's controlling you?
How
and
is
do you
he
think it's toxic for you?
should actually help Hana together and try to solve the situation together. Because you are a friend of us.
I understand, but we have to understand where Marcus is coming from. But why don't you want to talk to him first and let him understand? You know, as a woman, you also have to understand what a man is.
Pause. Okay. Can you give a round of applause?
In the beginning, I thought that Emily didn't really try to understand Hannah's situation. And then I feel that by getting Emily on our side, just as a friend, as Sarah herself, I can't do it alone. I need somebody on my side, in a sense. I understand that she wants to let Hannah know that maybe she could try to understand Marcus better, because Marcus cannot be that of a bad boyfriend. But I feel that if I can try to convince Emily, I didn't do quite a good job, but if I could try to get Emily to understand Hannah better, maybe the situation can be better. To make it that Emily can like do together with me to help talk to Marcus together. And then, I mean, that's not what Hannah wanted, but then like, to have her on our side so that we can work on it together. Yeah.
I think that was a very strong effort. Thank you. What does everyone think about that intervention?
I have a question.
Sure.
For Emily, right, yeah. She talked about her wife being something related to a good woman, right? Can you define that? Do you mind defining what you mean by a good woman?
Okay, so my character, Emily, believes that women should be very forgiving. They should be very nurturing and loving and understanding of a man. So if, let's say, a man is very aggressive, she should try to, you know, tone it down. She should try to help him calm down and stuff like that. So yeah, the woman should.
That's part of the relationship.
Oh.
Just for clarification,
where do you get this idea from? May I ask?
Society.
Yeah, I really believe, especially at home, that's what it's like. Because when my dad gets really, really angry, you know, my mom will try to like calm him down and everything. And she's very loving when she tries to understand him. Yeah, sometimes he can be a bit aggressive, but at least she knows how to.
Even if your mom is hurt in the process,
well,
so it's never your dad's fault.
He never physically abuses her. So I think it's just a couple trying to solve their own problems.
But it's, you know, like...
May I add a bit?
Yeah, sure.
So just new understanding of family, what would you like to do?
I would like to change her mindset, actually. Like, it's very hard to do.
So you like to rechange your mindset?
Yeah.
By playing another character, maybe?
It's okay. Thank you, Emily.
Maybe we should consider as an audience that despite this mindset that Emily has, she still tried to help Hannah at the end. Did she?
Yeah, she did.
Why do you think that was the case?
Because it's gotten so bad.
It's a very good point. So perhaps Emily could be encouraged to do something at the end? Or perhaps something could have been done for Hannah at the end of the play?
What did Nick say?
Yeah,
it's
not shit.
Oh yeah, it's not shit. But you want to be a good man.
Where is the nudes? Oh yes, I. So, would you like to, shall we watch the crisis scene one more time? And then perhaps, if you have an intervention to suggest, you can raise your hand and say pause. How does that sound?
Yeah.
Okay, let's start from Hannah grabbing the phone from Marcus. Yeah.
Stop it!
What the hell, Anna?
You see, you hated them!
We're not talking.
talking about this now?
Just give me the phone!
I said stop it, Marcus! Is this how you want to be treated?
Marcus, what's wrong with you? She's a girlfriend, dude.
Stop. Please! Oh.
Stay out of this.
I mean it. Stop treating her like this.
Trying to act like such a decent guy, huh? You sure didn't act this way when I show you her nudes. Tell me, hypocrite!
You fucking creeps! Marcus, how could you do something like that? I'm done, Marcus! I'm done!
What do you say?
It's over! I can't do this anymore!
You bitch! You can't just leave me like this!
I'm gonna call the police!
I dare you to!
Sir, I'm gonna call the police!
You heard Hana, screw off!
You're actually defending him right now?
You don't understand!
What the hell is wrong with you, Hana? If you're not going to help yourself, I really don't know who can. I don't know what to do.
Sarah! Look at what you've done!
Even your best friend left you. Who else is going to be here for you now? I'm giving you one last chance. One click on this phone and your whole life will be over forever.
Stop.
Then your family, you know, our obedient slut your daughter really is.
Hey, come on, we have to help her.
Forget it. It's not shit to do with.
What kind of man are you?
Why do you keep making me hurt you? You know I love you, but why do you keep making me hurt you?
I'm stupid.
Jesus. I'm sorry.
Oh my god. So,
are you going to suggest an intervention?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What would you like to do?
You know that part where I was. Sarah,
like, she said, I'm not going to call the police. Before that, can I intervene from
there? I want to just try intervening, like, as Sarah. So, Sarah. Why would you like to intervene as Sarah? I feel that there's so much more she can do as a friend. Yeah.
Okay.
She's not. I think if she tried hard enough, actually, like, make a difference.
So, you like to try and be a bit more persistent?
Yay! Can I try?
Yeah, sure. Okay, you can try. So, I guess I would remind you that because you played the role of Sarah, and that's and in this scene, she has very close proximity with Marcus, it's going to remind you that you will never be hit by this guy over here. But also, are you comfortable with maybe mild physical contact?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
It wouldn't be anywhere. It wouldn't be anywhere.
Yeah, no worries.
Okay.
She boy time. She's gonna smack her.
Let's begin with Hannah. Is everyone ready?
Yeah.
Alright.
It's over, Marcus! I can't do this anymore!
What do you say?
Please, Marcus, I want to get out of this relationship! I can't!
You bitch! You can't just leave me like this!
Hey, push up!
Hurt, even like getting more hurt, then like being hurt.
have the characters themselves get your age, starting with Emily over there.
I'm also 18 years old.
I'm going on to 19.
Oh, okay. Okay, then, if she reports to the police, they won't tell the parents, but she's not technically a minor anymore.
You mentioned 16 got autonomy, I think.
From what I understand is, right, if you have sex at 16 or and under, right, your parents will know it's a crime.
Yeah.
But then
after 16 is legal.
This is not an issue that were brought to the parents, right?
I think it's the photography part.
She's afraid that her parents know that
but if they report and police don't tell the parents, then they will never find out that she took such pictures.
No, if she reports to the police, then Marcus will immediately retaliate by posting it online and her life is ruined forever.
I have a question. Isn't the idea of posting somebody else's nude online illegal? Revenge porn, isn't that illegal? Rob Kardashian did that and he got his Instagram account deleted.
Perhaps you might consider that the nudes may not be the only reason why Hannah does not want Marcus to be reported. Do you think there's any other reason Hannah could have for not wanting Marcus to be reported?
She loves the asshole.
Perhaps she does. So, does anyone have other interventions to propose during the crisis scene? Or perhaps if you feel...
Tom.
You like to go back to the barbecue scene? Where everyone's there or just with the girls there?
The girls.
Just the girls here. Is this before Sarah pulls Hannah aside? Or is this
when Hannah?
Okay,
when Sarah pulls Hannah aside.
Okay, can we go back to the girls' barbecue scene? Okay, is everyone ready?
Yeah.
Come on, Hannah, I know you. Is it Marcus?
Yeah, he's been really unreasonable lately. He just accused me of trying to cheat on him.
Why does he always think that?
I don't know. It's just one of his flaws. I've been thinking of how I should talk to him about it.
Is it just me who prefers a guy who cares too much and too little? I'm sorry for eavesdropping, but I think that's just Marcus's way of showing his...
Emily, there's a difference between love and Stockholm Syndrome. Hannah, I think you should just break up with him already.
That's an overreaction, Sarah.
Hannah, come on. I'll go with you right now if you want.
Stop.
Okay, stop. So, Andrew, you'd like to intervene in this? Do you have a comment? Make a suggestion, perhaps?
You say first.
Okay, I think, right, she can try convincing both Emily and Hannah that that's not love. And then at that point in time, right, when after she convinced her, they straight away, like, report. Or find solutions online.
Why do you think that's an effective intervention? Or that can be an effective intervention?
I think it's because if we go to the crisis scene, right, it'll be too heated already, and it's like too late. And now it's just, yeah, in a safer space with just the girls, although like Emily has a different view.
Okay. So would you like to take the role of Sarah to try that?
Okay.
Okay, can we give a round of applause
for
Bob? Can you introduce yourself to the audience?
I'm Andrea.
Thank you, Andrea. begin when Sarah pulls head outside.
Hannah, what's wrong?
It's Marcus. He's been really unreasonable lately. He just accused me of trying to cheat on him.
What happened?
He saw that there's this guy, my classmate Alex, texting me. Because I'm the class chairperson and he accused me that, well, I'm cheating on him. It's unreasonable.
Did
anything else happen? Like, did you guys argue about anything else?
No. I know you, Hannah. Something's wrong. You can tell me, okay? I'm here for you.
Okay. I think that's just Marcus's way of showing he loves her, okay? He just cares a lot for her. And maybe that sometimes he does feel jealous and stuff, but Marcus just loves you a lot.
Emily, I know you care about her, but maybe we should hear from her.
Okay. Now what? What happened? Yeah, he just accused me of cheating on him. That's all, Sarah.
So it's not a big deal, you know? Like, maybe he just feels insecure and stuff. Like, maybe you could talk to him again. Like, why is he feeling so sad?
Well, I tried talking to him about it. Well, there's many times where I tried talking to him about it, but it seems like he wanted to change. You know, Sarah, we just need time to change, right?
Yeah, but has he been, like, doing anything wrong to me? Like, I heard you guys arguing just now at the beach side.
What? But they argue all the time. Couples argue all the time, Sarah. You have to understand.
Okay, yeah, I don't know why you take everything so seriously. Emily, is it okay if I talk to you?
I want to be there for Anna, so I want to know. And I'm my best friend, right? So
we'll update you later.
Stop. Okay, give you a round of applause for Andrea. What was your intervention this time?
I was trying to get Hannah to confide in us so that we can do something to support her.
Do you think that worked?
Yes, because Hannah actually told me Emily is here. So I got her to trust me. I just needed to get Emily out so that she can. Even if I can't get Emily on our side, right, at least Hannah is willing to try.
Thank you, that was a very good intervention. Alright. What does everyone think about that? Did you think that anything else can be done during this point of time?
Not this point of time. Can I fast forward back?
Crisis.
The last part.
The last part,
like
the crisis.
I would replace it.
Sure. I think one thing we should consider during the crisis is maybe we should, as an audience, think about what Hannah's strategies are during the crisis to get what she wants. What do you think Hannah did to get what she wanted?
Try to listen.
Try to listen?
To leave him. Now she said she would leave.
She tried to break up with him. Okay. Anything else?
She tried to delete the photo.
She tried to grab the phone, yeah. Delete the pictures. Okay. That's what you're practicing. Who would you like to... You'd like to interview this Nick, right? In his conversation with Marcus?
Part where
Emily
asks James.
Okay.
Wait,
Sarah has left that scene by that point of time.
Okay.
Olivia. Okay, thank you. This. Is everyone ready? Let's begin. Let's begin with a conversation between Emily and Nick. Yeah.
At this point, you haven't posted.
Nick, come on, we have to help her.
Okay.
Not supposed to do this. She's your girlfriend.
Okay.
didn't act this way earlier, so why acting this way now?
What can I do at that point of time?
What point of time? No, why do you want the phone?
Photos!
For what?
It's not... You were not in the right to take photos of her.
A lot of boyfriends have
that. Also, you want your mother's nudes on me. So, if you saw your mother's nudes on the internet, would you be happy? Okay, let's say you have a daughter. If your nudes are posted on the internet, would you be happy?
No.
Why are you doing this to her?
It's not like I will show anyone else.
It's not like you would. You were about to post it on the internet.
Only if she leaves me.
Oh, so it's right. If she leaves you, you're gonna post it on the internet. Why? What do you think?
Just delete the photos.
Yeah, delete the photos.
No, she's gonna leave me.
Okay, can you tell us a bit more about what you were trying to do?
Because Nick wanted her to be a friend. Oh, he done something to like actually help and yeah, and then like since he as a man like perhaps a little bit of connect better, right? Maybe could like put some sense in the thing she's not saying. So yeah, Nick you should have done.
How did you try and connect to Marcus?
By
he wants to be
giving him a name, like talking about like if he had a daughter, right, if he want his daughter's needs to be put on that. Yeah, and he wants to meet soon.
That's a good intervention.
Yeah, I tried to tell her.
So what he tried to do was he tried to make a change by using analogy to appeal to Marcus. Would anyone? What does everyone feel about that intervention? What was that?
I think Olivia just summed up the whole of Nick's personality, which is respect women. Right.
Andrew brought up a good point, like saying like, because Marcus, right, he wants to be banned. So if he posts the images online, right, maybe his reputation or image might be ruined because you know there are a lot of social justice warriors on the net. Like they will of course react to it very violently. So maybe I could at that point tell you about the repercussions of him posting pictures on the net. Yeah.
Can I clarify? When I say lead, I don't mean in the leadership position sort of sense, but I mean like as a man taking charge of my family, making decisions like that. Mm. Yeah, not
and
so much leadership positions.
Okay.
But you say your dad abuses your mom, right?
Yes.
You love your mom, right?
Yeah.
But you're doing the same thing to your girlfriend.
Only because now she's asking for it.
So
really
was your mom asking
it,
for it?
Would you like to make that same appeal as a character on stage? Okay.
I'm too emotional.
Okay. But those are some important questions about what Marcus is doing, what he's doing. Perhaps it gives us some ideas about how we can work towards the situation. We all agreed at the start that we wanted to work towards trying to prevent the abuse that happens towards Hannah. But what could Hannah have done for herself? We mentioned some strategies that Hannah took just now. She attempted to break up with Marcus, but did she try anything else before the crisis?
She tried to delete the pictures.
Sorry?
Delete the pictures.
She tried to delete the pictures. Anything else?
She actually did try to tell you.
She told a friend. She told a friend. She told a friend. And what did she do after telling a friend? Perhaps after the barbecue scene. What happened during the barbecue scene between Marcus and Hannah? When the boys came back and Marcus and Hannah got into another fight, what were they fighting about?
Alex. Is it? No, another one.
Would you like to rewatch the scene one more time?
We have time.
Oh, okay. Maybe we don't have time to watch that scene one more time.
Just sum up for us.
Okay, so
it. What? The scene.
Wonderful.
Oh, okay, no, just sum it up for us.
Okay. So in conclusion, our play talked about adolescent dating violence. And we covered some important topics about why guys might feel
that they might need to use abuse to control their relationships. We talked about why girls sometimes are unwilling to step up and themselves try and help their friends get out of these situations. So at the end of the day, I'd like to bring you back to that question that I asked you at the start of the play. How do gender stereotypes affect dating relationships? That's pretty much it. Does anyone else have a take, have their own takeaway they want to share with anyone? Well, I hate to leave us all with that negative impression, but if that's what you've got.
No, 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 no.
We had a conversation going about if I had a daughter, right?
No.
Okay. That you said that about mother, sorry, that yeah, I'm doing the same thing. Okay. But my character feels that it's the only way to take control of his girlfriend when he already feels like he's losing her. Not in the sense where they're gonna break up, but he's losing that dominance over her. Yeah. So perhaps it might be worth it to examine I guess what are the values that's making him think in that light, and then to talk about it. Because I think for my character, the breaking point would be if you reason to me that all forms of abuse are not exclusive to just physical abuse, but also through verbal language. But at the same time, it's also about because I think my character also has the mindset: how else can I take control of my girlfriend? Aside from being forceful or being mean.
Thank you for watching our production of Marcus and Hannah.